night in the small town, starless and vibrant black. The cobbled streets silent, and the hunched rabbits and quarters go limping down invisible to the slow black, crow black fish for bobbing sea. The houses are blind as moles, the mossy fine tonight with the smelting velvet dingoes. Hush, the babies are sleeping. The farmers, the fishers, the tradesmen, the pensioner, the undertaker and the fancy women, the wet foot cockle women and the tidy wives. Time passes. Listen, time passes. Come closer now. From where you are in the spring moonless night in Cockle Row, you can hear Miss Price, dressmaker and sweet shopkeeper, dream of her lover, tall as a town clock tower, and flailing with his eyes like glow lamps and sweeping low over her hot water bottled body.
Oh, Mr. Mog Edwards!
Throw away your little bed socks and your Welsh wool knitted jacket. He will warm the sheets like an electric toaster. He will lie by your side like the Sunday roast.
Oh, Mr. Mog Edwards, I will knit you a wallet, a forget-me-not blue, for the money, to be comfy. I'll warm your heart by the fire, so you may slip it under your vest when the shop is closed.
Me fan me, before the mice gnaw at your bottom drawer, will you say?
Yes, Mog, yes, Mog, yes, yes, yes! Oh, what will the neighbours say? What will the neighbours say?
Poor Mrs. Weldon.
What she pet set,
never should have married.
If she didn't have to.
Mother.
Let her husband call.
Where is his father? Well,
do you know where he ended?
Up in the asylum.
Dying policeman.
Every Saturday.
He hasn't gone there.
And carrying on.
And Mrs. Beattie Marlett.
Where is
he? I haven't seen her,
baby. Oh, it's got his nose.
My God.
What he'll do for a drink.
It's all the pianola.
And a sewing machine.
Falling in the gutter.
Don't get to a lamppost.
Singing in the W.
Oh, Mrs. Weldon.
Waldo! Waldo!
Yes, Summer.
Oh, what will the neighbours say? What will the neighbours?
Look at the chimney.
What are you doorbells?
Breaking windows.
Making my pies.
Stealing currants.
Talking words.
Throwing in the bushes.
Playing muffins.
Sent him to bed without any supper.
Give him centipod to lock him in the dark.
Off to the reformatory.
Off to the reformatory.
Learn him with a slipper on his BTM.
Mrs. Rose Cottage's eldest maid peels off her pink and white skin in a hurdle in a tower in a cave in a waterfall in a wood, and waits there, raw as an onion, for Mr. Wright to leap up the burning tall splashes of leaves like a brilliant teened trout.
Call me Dolores, like they do in the stories.
Time passes. Listen, time passes. An owl flies home past the first star, and the dawn inches up. Now, walk the glass by the outer bed, sleepyhead, Polly put the kettle on, town hall bell, Lily Smalls, Mrs. Bailey's treasure, comes downstairs from a night of dreams, and puts the kettle on the primus ring in Mrs. Bailey's kitchen, and goes over to Mr. Bailey's shaving glass and sees.
Oh, there's a face. Where'd you get the nerve from, Billy?
I got it from an old tomcat. Well, give it back then, Nerve.
Oh, there's a pen. Where'd you get that nose from, Lily?
I got it from my father, silly.
Well, you got it on upside down. Oh, there's a conch.
Look at your complexion. I can't you look?
Oh, there's Grandma.
Where'd you get that smile in?
Never you mind, girl. Nobody loves you.
Ah, that's what you think.
Who is it loves you then, Lil?
I shan't tell.
Come on, Lily.
Cross your heart, then.
Cross my heart.
And very softly, her lips almost touching the reflection, she breathes the name and clouds the glass.
Lily!
Yes, ma'am?
Where's my tea gun?
Where do you think? In the cab box. Come and get it, ma'am.
Me, Polly Garter, giving the breast in the garden to my bonny new baby. Nothing grows in our garden, only washing. And babies. And where their fathers live, my love? Over the hills and farther. You're looking up at me now. I know what you're thinking. You're no better than you should be, Polly. Not good enough for me. Oh, isn't life a terrible thing, thank God. Now, frying pan spit and kettles and cats purr in the kitchen. The whole town smells of seaweed for breakfast. But it may you and Mrs. Oswald Pritchard thinks that her starch in the stove and sips lemon rind tea down to the bottom cottage where Mr. Baldo squeaks from the salt bottom and gobbles his bubble and squeak and kippers. The women scratch and babble in Mrs. Orban Morgan's general shop where everything is sold. Buckets, henna, rat traps, sugar, confetti, paraffin, hatchets, whistles.
Mrs. Oldmore Pritchard!
Oh, do you
know? Got a man in Bilgwell.
And you got a telescope to look at the birds. The member there first has been deeded. Yeah. Didn't need a telescope.
Oh, he was looking at them and dressing through the keyhole.
And he used to shout, tally ho!
But Mr. Oldmore was a proper gentleman.
And even though he hanged his collie. Oh,
have you seen that Mrs. Butcher Bing?
She is.
Mrs. Butcher Bing, you put dogs in the midst.
Go on, he's pulling her leg.
Now don't you dare tell her that there's a deer.
Oh, sure, he's trying to pull it up and eat it.
Well, there's a nasty lot of hair when you come to bed.
Mm. Look at that no good boy now.
Too lazy to wipe his.
No. Going out fishing every day and all you ever brought up was Mrs. Samuel.
Being in the water a week.
Oh, wait, look at fucking open point that nobody's ever seen.
Open there in the cupboard with all the empties.
We have died for that with two wives.
Oh.
One for the morning, one for the night.
Men are
flutes of the quiet.
Oh. Who's Organ Morgan, Mrs. Morgan?
He looked dead beat.
It's organ all the time with him.
Every night and